The situation that we've been facing, particularly in recent days and weeks in Victoria for aged care, has been very distressing. It is very distressing, first and foremost, to the families of those who have loved ones in aged care facilities. The most vulnerable in our community have always been our highest concern when it comes to managing the health issues associated with this pandemic. That has always been true for the elderly, but it has also been true for those who have many other comorbidities, those who are undergoing chemotherapy treatment, those in Indigenous communities in remote areas. We have always been very aware of those who have been most vulnerable in our community. And elderly persons, particularly those in facilities, which these days, as we know, aged care has changed. It's one of the reasons why I called the Royal Commission into aged care, because the nature of the demands on our aged care services have changed. In many ways, aged care facilities, in many instances, have become a form of pre-palliative care in Australia. Many years ago, that was quite different. But these days, particularly with the in-home aged care options that we are continuing to expand across the country, more Australians are choosing, and it's a good choice to be able to make, to remain at home. But those who are moved into aged care facilities are often moved in at a much more advanced stage. And all of us who have had to make those decisions in relation to loved ones understand that. And so I think that attaches to it a particular sensitivity in the challenges that we're now facing. The challenges of dealing with aged care are not unique to Australia. And indeed, in every country in the world where there is sustained community transmission, it is inevitable that this will find its way into aged care facilities. When it rains, everyone gets wet. And that is what we're seeing with broad-based community transmission in Victoria. As the Premier rightly said, if you are ill, do not go to work. That is true if you work in a meat processing plant. It is true if you work in a chemist shop. It is true if you work in a restaurant. It is true if you're a journalist, a politician, whoever you may be, an aged care worker especially. We have, I think, over 750 healthcare workers, in particular in Victoria, who have been infected with COVID. This is the product of community transmission. And whatever workplace it is, then workplaces are vulnerable, and that's why the Victorian Government has rightly put in place the protections they have to try and protect against that workplace transmission. Now, in relation to aged care facilities in Victoria, there are over 430 such facilities in Melbourne. It's a large number of facilities. We have seen some very distressing and concerning situations arise in a handful of those facilities. In facilities such as St Basil's, in facilities such as Epping Gardens, where we've been working very consistently over recent days, in Kirkbray. There are a range of other facilities where there have been COVID cases, around 13, that we are keeping a very close watch on. And there are facilities outside of that list of 13 who are obviously in areas where there is community outbreak, which we are also watching, but they are in not what you'd call the critical list of facilities where we have a keen level of focus. So it's important to understand, because I can understand of people in Victoria or even elsewhere, as they're seeing unfold the very distressing stories out of St Basil's and the other facilities that have been affected most acutely, that they would have concerns about the facility where their family is. The good news is broadly across the aged care system in Victoria, we have been able, together, working together with the Victorian Government, able to avoid those quite distressing scenes in the overwhelming majority of those facilities. But we will not be complacent about it, and the establishment of the Victorian Aged Care Response Centre has been a key initiative to ensure that we continue to stay on top and hopefully ahead of any potential threats that may emerge in those facilities.